here.
What about the black box sign?
Sticker.
What about my baseball bat that I used to chase the children?
No sticker, but good example, Grant. Thank you. Okay, now, everyone, get to work packing.
You guys, I'm really bummed about leaving Vacation Lane. This building is so special.
What are you talking about? This building is falling apart. We get to have a brand new building next year. How exciting is that?
Yes.
We think about all the quotes on the walls, all the memories.
I'm happy.
Thank you.
calling it back.
Yeah, we have Henry Hammer with 24.
Oh, God.
Woo!
Oh, God.
Like, actually, mice.
Yeah. You cannot take the mice. No sticker.
Yeah, they took it.
Losers, please.
Jasper Award for theater.
No relation.
So Caitlin Papadin was a graduate of HB Woodlawn, and during her time here, she was active in the theater program. She was known as Jasper among her theater colleagues, and this scholarship is given in her memory. So the criteria for this are someone who has given outstanding contributions to the HB Woodlawn theater program and has shown dedication to multiple facets of the theater program.
And you might be having a really hard time with this senior class figuring out who it might go to. Because this has been an incredible group for theater ever since we met them in sixth grade. But some of them have acted, directed, even stage managed, etc., etc., and even music directed. It's so true. This award goes to Miss Ariel Shakespeare!
I just can't find any of my staplers. I don't know where to put them. I can't handle this.
Elizabeth, I'm like becoming unraveled. Do you think you can help me pick the swatch for the fabric to decorate my room next year?
Siobhan, you've got to make time for me.
Different.
turned away from it all like a blind man. Saw the things that I don't know. Need some slash and torn.
I think they have an overhead.
Yeah, Bill!
Okay. Good musical number, middle school chorus. You might identify with that number well, too. And so now we're queuing up music awards. Carl Reese and I are here to present those students who did honor ensembles throughout the year and also won class awards. So to kick it off, I'm going to ask for these students to stand as a group. So when you hear your name, take a stand, and then we'll applaud for them after all of that group is standing. So this is for Arlington County Middle School Honor Chorus. Riley Shinar, Fana Dereje, Kate Gorman, Meredith Lawler, Megan McBride, Dalit Maluich, Marlena Nagel, Harper Srinivasan, Charlotte Thomas, and Sam Thomas.
School honor bands in the junior honors band. Let's wait till we get all these in. We've got Malia Ornelas, Grant Wilco, and Sarah Baumgarten. And then for the honors band, which is 7th and 8th grade, we had Gabby Everett and Lucy Greco, and we had Micah Lynch Lee and Nolan Riordan.
Arlington County Junior Honors Orchestra, we had Nicola Beaumont. And for the Arlington County 7th and 8th grade Honors Orchestra, we have Lily Baylor.
Then we have our All-District Honor Choirs. So this is Middle School All-District. Riley Shenard, Megan McBride, Oliver Andres, Siddharth Advani, Asher Connor, and Eli Gall made it into Honor Choirs.
At the middle school level, the All-District Junior Band, we have Lucy Greco.
For High School All-District Chorus, Maggie Baldwin, Andrew Bracken, Elizabeth Brown, Ellie Klo, Ephraim Connor, Owen Curtis, Jack Dunham, Lily Dunn, Ben Fleming, Lex Garcia, Grace Goldman, Philip Juris, Lily Claymire, Andrew London, Evangeline McEwen, Ellie McCabe, Ella McHugh, Katie Moore, Annabelle Mudge, Maya Ovando, Mary Edith Plunkett, Katie Rao, Ella Richard, Isabella Russo, Audrey Smith, Brooke Tanner, Lucy West, and Lucy West. That should have been a cadence.
And for the all-district band at the high school level, we have Audrey Smith.
Yeah!
And she didn't stop there, because then she auditioned for the all-state band, and she got the second highest audition score on French horn in the entire Commonwealth. So let's give it for Audrey.
For all Virginia senior honor choir, Annabelle Mudge. All Virginia Choir, it's just called All Virginia Choir. Andrew London and Brooke Tanner. For ACDA National Middle School Honor Chorus, Siddharth Advani.
Yes!
And for the National High School Honor Choir, Grace Goldman.
H.P. Woodlawn Middle School Orchestra Awards, they go to Casey Pick and Ellie Alexander. And the National School Orchestra Award goes to Ahmed Matera, who I think is not here, but we remember him, and he's made a great part in our orchestra, even though he'd never played bass before. So Ahmed Matera first.
Band award for the 6th and 7th grade age block group, that went to Daniel Gates, 6th grade. And in our 8th grade B block class, our secret weapon award went to Josh Leitner.
Yes!
For the Louis Armstrong Jazz Award, that went to Eli Tao. Award for the high school wind ensemble, that went to Tam Ayers.
Yes!
For the class award for middle school treble chorus, Riley Chenard. For middle school basso, Asher Connor. For high school treble, Charlotte Mulligan. For high school basso, Noah Trope. Caroline Darnell. The chamber singers, Annabelle Mudge. And for the National School Choral Award, Grace Goldman. Those are our music awards.
Hello, I'm Heather Spence. I'm here representing Michelle's Earth Foundation. So I'm an alum of H.B. Woodlawn. And I'm here to present the Michelle's Earth Foundation Award. Michelle Gardner-Quinn and I went to H.B. together. We were actually stand partners in the orchestra. We both played cello. And she was a fantastic human being, an H.B.er, and really involved in a lot of important environmental work. And so this award is in her honor, and the organization is as well. And basically, we're going to be support. We want to make sure that all of you carry on her vision for a sustainable planet, and carry on that work. And so this award is for somebody who embodies that.
Has conducted science fair. Research on estuary grasses, has served as a student board member of Arlingtonians for a Clean Environment, and as a leader of HB's environmental club, along with some other leaders we've had. She has also taught short Bab Fest classes on environmental topics. This year's recipient is Chloe Hugel.
So excited that we're going to get a chance to reform my band, Shabunkin.
Yes!
Yeah.
While running a marathon. He was a great representative of the HB Woodlawn culture. He was friendly, warm, outgoing, and a great supporter of students. The recipient of the Pat Riley Scholarship should give active service in helping people, show a willingness to fight for the underdog, and have acceptance of all kinds of people. The student who will be receiving the Pat Riley Scholarship this year has gone out of her way to help mentor younger students. She intuitively offers gentle guidance and genuine praise to encourage struggling students. She makes sure that students new to HMC, MGA, and Model UN know the ropes. She's been a helper to numerous teachers in everything from grading papers and organizing trips. She notices when work needs to be done and selflessly steps in to do it, whatever is needed, totally under the radar, never seeking spotlight for herself. This student is always warm and supportive of others. She has a sixth sense for knowing when people need support, a boost, a positive word, and she gives those things generously with no thought of reward. And no doubt it would make Pat happy that this student has been a faithful member of the math team for several years. This year's Pat Riley Scholarship goes to Gigi Ebert.
Scholarship. Judy was a well-loved librarian at HB for nearly 30 years. She died in 2000 after a long battle with breast cancer. The scholarship in her honor was established in the spring of 2001 by a committee of students and staff looking to commemorate her life. A published poet, she was a special friend to countless numbers of students and staff. This scholarship is given in her memory. The criteria for the scholarship are skilled in creative writing, kind, caring, unbiased, and a good listener, someone who looks out for others, particularly the overlooked, and they are an active service in the larger community. This year's recipients of the Judy Mayhew Scholarship exemplifies all of these. This person has a wonderfully creative flair in writing and in most things, quite frankly. They are incredibly kind and regularly go out of their way in support of the underdog. They have proven their worth to the HB community on numerous occasions, including our community day, and as an unflappable, incredibly capable NHS officer. I am proud to present the 2019 Judy Mayhew Scholarship to Brees Walker.
Just a
good job packing. But the bad news is that every storage area in Northern Virginia is now full of your stuff. So you each can only take one more thing.
Oh, no!
Wait, I haven't even started packing my cup makers.
And I still have 7 boxes of post-it notes and highlighters.
Okay, enough. You are just gonna have to choose. You each get one more sticker.
This is just too shady. I don't know what to take.
Is this a clue? Yep, this is the Kahoot.
So many
bikes. My God, if people start putting bots in. As usual. When Tyler, the IT person, is running the computer, something goes wrong.
Wait 15 seconds to get ready.
I'm slow. God, you're calling me this is loaded.
It took a while.
That says Kahoot. Click play on the left screen.
Get off the Wi-Fi.
Thanks, APS.
Okay. So, we're going to first all sing the Kahoot song while Brian leads us to the Kahoot dance.
Close the other tab.
Alright, that's okay. We'll see if it happens.
Oh my god. Oh.
And yes. Yeah, we use the auto generate because we met you.
Yeah,
Oh my God.
You are doing it wrong.
Maybe they shouldn't have said a thing that makes it so that it happens. I think you're in the wrong. You're in the wrong head.
Someone's gonna walk in and
no. The one that had everyone in it.
Yeah, I know.
Except me.
Holy cow, that's our class. Woo! No.
I wonder how many trees Carolyn uses a year. picture.
Chair or secretary in town meeting, but has helped younger students learn how to do the same. She's volunteered hours of her time registering voters and making phone calls on behalf of the New Virginia Majority, which is a nonpartisan organization. She's led FebFest on political action and helped lead political actions at our school and in the community. She was a co-creator of our GSA and started the UNICEF Club at HB. She's so dedicated to the amazingness of HB's value of self-governance that she went through all 18 years of our town meeting archives and created a list of all the bylaws we've passed since the original constitution. The HB community is going to miss her leadership dearly next year. The recipient of the Ray Anderson Scholarship this year is Brooke Tanner.
Slightly to the music here. So Frank, you are 100% musical and you are 100% selfless. And so we wanted to recognize someone from the senior class who is also 100% musical and 100% selfless. This is someone who I think is just a kindred spirit with that guy right here. And so Patty is going to recognize our winner.
In addition to his love of music, the recipient of this award must be like Frank, compassionate,
caring, dedicated to serving HB and the larger community. Like Frank, this student has a long history of working with youth with disabilities. He's a devoted member of the Stratford Friends, and he just spent his experience teaching music at Stratford. He's a captain of the Arlington Action Team, and the one who always shows up with a smile and a helping hand. Like Frank, he probably isn't the loudest person in the room, but he just might be the strongest. The scholarship goes to Henry Knocker.
Why does this only happen when the IT person's running it?
The end of the teacher play.
What?
Wait for it. When the police know. No. Hitachi!
Hitachi!
Blank screen.
Two things in one are just playing better. Like the two.
Yeah!
Judy.
Department. So, Lauren Youngdahl, thank you for all you've done. stage, I hope, so they can step forward. But the next person, it's hard to believe that they have only been here for 3 years. They have made a tremendous impact on our theater program in those 3 years. In terms of our tech program, in terms of directing, in terms of being here for students at all hours of the day and night, HB Woodlawn Theater is in a different place now thanks to the hard work of this person who is heading off to become an actor himself. And we want to thank Josh Rosenblum for everything. Even without them here, I know that they have set an amazing foundation for our theater program and our film program to grow from. And I just want us to thank Tom Mallon for all he's done. Thank you, Tom. Decided to finish his career here at HB Woodlawn. So our Spanish department is so fortunate, those of you that have taken Spanish, the level of instruction that this person has brought to our building, but also the kind of love and support for his colleagues has been unparalleled. So I want to have us give it up and thank Michael Mandel. It is my other home. Every one of us has been shaped by our time here. And for those of you who graduate this year, and those of you who will be here for 6 more years, thank you for keeping this a place that values trust and choice and caring about people. We're going to take a moment, and just as we do with our seniors, we will graduate this building. So this is our graduation speech to 4100 Vacation Land. What do you say about a building like 41 Vacation Land? Built in 1950 in the international style as Stratford Junior High, the building witnessed a historic moment as the first school in Virginia to desegregate in February of 1959. It became the home of H.B. Woodlawn in 1978. It's a quirky little place. It has a fish pond. It has a ground level entrance on every one of its four floors. It patiently accepted our murals, our senior walls, our late night play practices, outdoor and indoor frisbee throwing, and an endless supply of used couches. It absorbed our joys and our sorrows and kept us safe, all of us, students, staff, and the H.B. Woodlawn program itself as we came of age. 4100 Vacation Lane has been, first and always, a place to learn. History, music, math, reading, drama, science, and art have been our primary pursuits. But more importantly, Vacation Lane served as a classroom for life, for growing up, making friends, finding our passions, and for breaking and healing our hearts. 4100 Vacation Lane graduates today from the H.B. Woodlawn program. Vacation Lane will continue its life in public education by serving a new group of Arlington students. But like many graduates of H.B. Woodlawn, this building may now wear a coat and tie to work, but underneath, it will always have H.B. Woodlawn tattoos. Farewell, Vacation Lane. We thank you.
Thank you.
Wyla? It's Michael.